First day of school, I remember coming out here, seeing all the people I didn't know. It was a good time.
Everyone was really friendly. We signed each other's planners with our phone numbers and screen names.
I remember most freshman football. That's like one of my major memories. It was craziness. It was a lot of fun.
Freshman year?
Oh, Father Nolan telling me that I was a hoochie and that I needed to button my second butt because I had two unbuttoned and
Nolan.
I didn't know that was a bad thing.
Yeah, it was last year and we missed it very much. Left hand year. And first day of school was really fun because.
So scary.
It was really scary.
Oh my god. Mr. Moak, he's like, get out of homeroom and go find your classes. And we're walking around and we're like, which building is the 200s? And we didn't know that it was right upstairs.
With our little maps, we didn't know what we were doing.
We were going.
Yeah, it was really fun though.
My first memory was meeting Denise for the first time. That's what I remember, always.
Yeah.
Freshman year, I think field day. I don't know.
Field day was pretty fun. Freshman year, it was just a time to make new friendships.
Wait, I remember the first day, everyone having, knowing each other, except me, I was, all by myself. Wow. And I fell down those little steps, you know where the freshman locker room is?
Yeah.
I fell down those steps.
I think you carrying all your books.
No, I don't know.
Well, I remember the second day of school, I fell on the steps. In front of everybody during passing time.
I don't remember
that.
And
they all made fun of me for years.
Ben! Falling down the stairs! And falling up the stairs, if you didn't get the falling down the stairs.
I fell down the stairs, and I have to go to my next class with ripped stockings.
Yeah, I know! Not being able to reach the top part of my locker, because I'm a little bit too short.
And hitting your head on it.
Oh my god, yeah!
And having
to apart. Yeah, they swing over and you're like, ow, okay.
First day of school, I remember walking into the wrong place twice. And then sitting down with everybody who I didn't know.
The first day of freshman year, I remember walking into the cafe and seeing a whole bunch of people that I didn't even know, and then sitting down with all of my friends.
Being scared. Too.
Yeah, being really, really scared, but I just remember sitting down with a couple girls, and they're still my friends today, so it kind of started off good and it's ending really good. I'm going to miss everyone, but I'm excited to move on and get to college. It's been a good 4 years, but it's time to move on.
Definitely gonna miss all my friends. I hope I can make friends that are just as loving and caring next year as I found here at Eustace.
Definitely miss the people, just because everyone was awesome here. Some of my teachers, the ones that passed me.
And the cookies in the cafe.
Oh, the cookies in the cafe are the best.
Probably my teacher, Mrs. Mazur.
I'm gonna miss the quad.
Yeah,
definitely.
I'm gonna miss hanging out in the quad, just sitting there and all.
I'm gonna miss my friends.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna miss Mr. Blystein. He really gave me good life lessons, and I'll never forget him.
I think that what I'll miss the most is the actual tennis team itself, because the girls, the bonds that you make with the girls on that team are just unbelievable. They're my best friends in the entire world, and I really don't know what I would do without any of them.
I probably miss seeing everybody every day.
Yeah, definitely.
We'll keep in touch with them if we do the same.
Probably the people. Definitely the people, our friends.
Seeing everybody all at once.
And the underclassmen. Miss them so much.
I guess seeing everyone every day.
Yeah. I'm going to miss each other. I hope we all keep in touch.
I think what I'm going to miss most is third lunch and partying on the weekends.
I'm going to miss partying with all my friends on the weekends. I'm going to miss them all a lot.
My final party groups are Party Hardy, class of 2003 Rocks. Derek, you're the man! You're the man, Derek!
I just want to wish everyone good luck in college, and hopefully we'll be able to come back in a couple years and see what me and my friends have made of ourselves, and we're all going to be happy with each other.
I guess just good luck to everyone. I'm going to miss everyone a lot. It's been a good 4 years, I got to say that.
Vinny, Vinny, Vici. I came, I saw, and I conquered. And good luck. That's all.
It's been a long 4 years, but now it's come to an end, and we've been through so much. The buses that we've all been on, the inside jokes, the dances.
That we've been through a lot, but we've definitely pulled together and been strong, and I love you guys. Basically, just stay true to yourself. Whatever you want to do with your life, you can do it, so live your dreams.
Okay, I'm going to quote Billy Joel and say, life is a series of hellos and goodbyes, and my friends, I'm sorry it's time for goodbye again. But everybody, just live without regrets.
Our class was really the best. I have mad class spirit.
I think we were the smartest, the fastest, the brightest, whatever. I just think we were the best.
To the class of 2003, I hope that you fulfill all of your endeavors and you become successful, and good luck in the next 4 years.
All of you to the senior class, the class of 2003, your senior prom. I want to let you know just how excited I am to be here and how excited I am for all of you to be here. On behalf of Father Joe, who I think you would understand is not able to be here this evening, I want you to know he sends his best wishes to you and hopes that you all have just a totally enjoyable evening and that we're all going to have a really, really great time.
As we do everything at Bishop Eustace, let us begin with prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Heavenly Father, on this night, we ask that you bless the food we are about to receive, bless the conversation shared, and all that we do this night, may we be under your love and your protection. And as always, we make this prayer through Christ our Lord, amen. St. Vincent Pallotti, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
So I just want to wish Miss Wishick has been with us for 4 years, put up with all our crap, namely last this year. They've been there for everything, helped us along a lot. I worked with them for 2 years now. Mike and Del have done it for a year. So we just have a little token of our appreciation to them. We wanted to thank you for basically putting your heart into our class and helping us in every way that you possibly could for the past 4 years. And to the senior class, it's your prom. Hope everyone's having a great time. If you're not, you can blame Del.
Del's fault.
But yeah, just have a blast. My great pleasure to announce to you the prom king for the class of 2003 for their senior prom, and that is Adam Holman. Adam, doing the honors will be Miss Wishnick. And the prom queen for the senior prom class of 2003, Lauren Kramer. Congratulations to the two of you.
had Kyle and Megan the whole time, so it was kind of weird. And all my friends all got all made weird noises, and I was just like, whatever. I was surprised.
I don't really have anything to say.
I don't know.
It was a shock.
What's your plan for the rest of the weekend? Going down the shore, probably. Margate and then Ocean City.
Prom 2003 was, it was fun. My date was an hour late picking me up, but it was good after that, and now I'm just hot, so.
Prom was really fun. My date doesn't dance, but that's okay. I'm having fun with all my friends, and that's it.
I can't wait to go down the shore and be with my friends.
It's the weekend, Margate down the shore. We were Dominique and Ryan Johnson.
He's an Booyah, AP. Shut.
It's time to stand up. It's time to jump. Jump. Jump around, House of Pain. Come to check out. Hope everybody had a great time. It's not over yet. Welcome the soon-to-be graduates of class 2003.
And when I was 18 and working, I had a tremendous surprise. Someone in the street moved out. I had never seen that before. Someone left, whole family. And then a whole family came in. And this new family came in with a daughter about my age. Her name was Marguerite. And I liked Marguerite. One day I left for work in the morning. And she had come out, she lived on the other side of the street, came out at the same time she was going to work. And we started to walk down the street, and because it's such a narrow street, we started to talk, and I was amazed I was doing this. Coherent, whole sentences were coming out of my mouth. I was not a babbling idiot. And it was going very nicely. We got toward the end of the street, and I was talking to Marguerite, and I looked, because I have to make a left-hand turn, go around the corner, get the bus. And as I turned around to look, I walked into a pole. And Marguerite came over to see if I was all right. And all the pride that I had had before that pole hit me, in being able to say single coherent sentences, that pride vanished. She said to me, "Are you all right?" And I said, "Don't worry about it. This happens a lot." But I'm telling you this because you've spent 4 years at Bishop Eustace. And you have had experiences there. Some of them maybe silly, some of them maybe even sad. Some of them are so wonderful, perhaps, that you had to work very hard to keep your feet on the ground. Some of them you think you're going to remember for the rest of your days. And all of those experiences come tomorrow night or tomorrow afternoon after the commencement ceremonies are over. All of those experiences will fall into the category irrevocably called memory. Some of these memories you will be able to call and call back again. Some you won't want to. But all of them will become part and parcel of who you become from here on in. What you have learned, how you have developed as a person, how you see the world, is much different tonight than it was 4 years ago when you entered Bishop Eustace, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, with your ties up around your neck, for those of you who wore ties. And all of that now becomes a memory. And that's a good thing, because we are, to a certain extent, the result of our experiences and our memories. The kind of person you were 4 years ago, if you think about it now, you might even chuckle at how you were then and how you are now. The person you are now, you may chuckle about 4 years from now, or 6 or 8 or 10 years from now. But you will have the memories. And those are important to remember, especially on a night like tonight. When you come together as the class of 2003.
I'm going to American University next year. I'm going to major in broadcast journalism.
I'm going to NC State, and I don't know. I'm going to decide it.
I'm going to American with Courtney, sadly. I'm going to major in law because I'm going to be famous, and I'm going to be a lawyer. And I'm going to make money.
I'm going to University of Delaware, and I'm going to major in medical technology to be a doctor.
I'm going to save your lives.
I'm going to NYU next year.
I'm going to Lafayette next year.
I'm going to study political science.
And I'm undecided, but business and probably minor in education.
The College of New Jersey, probably leaning towards something in business.
Just trying to have as good a time as possible this summer.
Hi, I'm John Paolini. I'm going to LaSalle University next year to study nursing.
I'm Brendan Connor. I'm going to Ursinus College, and I'll be studying probably medicine or biology.
I'm Chris. I'm going to Allegheny College to study neuroscience.
I'm going to Wake Forest in the fall, and I'm very, very excited, and I'm glad that it's finally over and we're all successful. And I'm going to Cabrini College next year, and I'm going to be studying business and marketing, and I'm really excited, but I'm nervous that it's over and sad that it's over.
And we're both going to Virginia Polytechnic Institute and State University, also known as Virginia Tech, where Michael Vick went. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're graduating today. It sucks that it's raining, stinks that it's raining, but it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm excited. How about your feelings, Paul?
I'm thrilled.
You're thrilled?
I'll be attending the United States Naval Academy. I leave July 1st to begin my basic training. And after that, probably just join the Army, Navy, and make a career out of it.
I'm going to Villanova with Erica. We're going together.
We're excited.
My name is Kelly, and I'm going to Philadelphia University to study business and Christine.
I'm going to Cabrini, and I'm studying education.
I'm going to Cabrini also, and I'm studying chemistry.
I'm Jenny, and I'm going to the University of Virginia, and I have no idea what I'm doing.
I'm Christine, hello, and I'm going to Fordham University next year, and I'm going to be studying communication. And I'm feeling wonderful because I'm surrounded by my friends and the people who matter to me, and it has been an awesome 4 years.
My name is Tony Walton, and I'm going to University of Hartford next year to study art and business.
Next year, I'm going to Penn State University, main campus, and I'll be studying business.
I'm going to Rowan, and I'm studying psych and minoring in dance.
I'm going to Syracuse, and I'm studying secondary education.
My name is Joel Pratt, and graduating Bishop Eustace, going on to Wesleyan University, play football, possibly run track, and that's about it.
My name is Mike Coyle. I'll be going to the University of Colorado, and we'll see what goes on out there.
Next year, I'm going to Gettysburg College. I don't really know what I'm studying yet. Me and my parents are kind of on edge about that. I want to go into psychology, and my parents want me to go into biology and pre-med. So, I don't know. I'm just excited because it's been great 4 years here. So,
I'm going to St. Joe's University. Next year, I'm going to be studying public administration. Here's mine.
Yeah, I'm going to Cabrini College, and I'm going to do communications.
I'm going to Florida Atlantic, and I'm undecided right now.
I'm going to Fordham University, and I'm going to major in business.
I'll be going to Monmouth University up in West Long Branch, New Jersey, to study criminal justice. My friend Brendan here is going to Drew University, also in New Jersey. What are you going for, Brendan? For economics, to further his career. Maybe we'll see you back in a couple years.
I'm kind of sad because I'm going to miss everybody, but I'm kind of glad also just to be getting out into the world.
It's a little weird for it all to be over, but I'm very excited.
My feelings tonight, I'm really excited even though it's raining. It's going to be really, really fun, and we're going to do a really good job singing.
I'm glad to be out, but I'm going to miss all these people that I spent 4 years with. But I'm going to miss all the people that I spent 4 years with.
I'm going to miss you, though.
members of the Board of Trustees, Dr. Coughlin, Mr. Bleistein, distinguished faculty, honored guests, Reverend fathers, brothers, religious sisters, and members of the class of 2003, I would ask that you remain standing for the opening prayer, for the national anthem, and for the Pledge of Allegiance. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Heavenly Father, we gather to celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2003. We ask for your blessings and love. This day is filled with joy and pride in the success and accomplishments of these young men and women. Yet our hearts are saddened as we bid farewell to another graduating class. Bless all who have helped to make this day possible, our parents, the faculty, the staff, and the administration. Especially bestow your blessing on the benefactors of Bishop Eustace, who generously make it possible to build the kingdom of God here in South Jersey. Inspire all of us in the words of St. Paul and in the motto of St. Vincent Pilate to let Christ's charity urge us on. And as always, we ask these blessings through Christ our Lord. Amen. Mary, Queen of Apostles, St. Vincent Pilate, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated. It is now my pleasure to introduce, on behalf of the class of 2003, Michael Lawrence Antonelli, who will deliver the welcoming address.
Good afternoon, Dr. Coughlin, Mr. Bleistein, Dr. Damor, Palatines, administration, members of the faculty, alumni, family, friends, and finally, fellow graduates. Welcome to the graduation ceremonies of the class of 2003. Life is a journey. There are people here today from all walks of life, but they can be placed into two distinct groups. The graduates of the class of 2003 and those that have helped us on our journey thus far. As we sit here this morning, both anxious and scared to take the next step in the journey of life, we must not forget the drive taken to reach this point. 4 years ago, this journey seemed impossible. We were forced to cross a bridge from our grade schools, where we had grown so comfortable, and were thrown into the driver's seat in a new environment, surrounded by strangers by the names of classmates and teachers. Many of us were overwhelmed by the changes of old routine and the demanding work from our classes. We were expected to meet a higher standard. Everything was so different that we did not know which way to turn. Slowly, very slowly, we began to drive forward. New friendships began to form and expectations were met. We had survived the merge to high school. Although in the back of our minds, we may have been longing for a shortcut to graduation, however, there was no shortcut, so we kept driving forward. Now that we have arrived, we look back and realize that the drive was not always an easy one. It was filled with wrong turns, potholes, and dead ends. Many times we became depressed, wanting nothing more than to just give up. Every one of us had sat through at least one class thinking to themselves that they would give anything to be somewhere else. There have been troubled times, quarreling friends, crowded schedules, frustration, and even the death of loved ones. These were obstacles that not many others could overcome, but not us. We always managed to find resolve and hope. We've been told over the last 4 years that God is always with us. But he is not just a companion on the journey. He is the driving force, the gas in our tanks. When times were at their worst, we relied on the gifts that God has given us to help carry us through, even though we may not have realized it. He has helped us through those closest to us, a teacher that gave us advice, family that have been so supportive, or a friend that you could talk to about anything. Without these gifts, it would have been impossible for us to carry on. To those that have graced us with your assistance, we would like to say thank you. Despite the many challenging roadblocks, we cannot forget the scenic roadways that we've enjoyed along the way. They are the dances, dates, snow days, trips, movies, retreats, and an infinite number of other times that we fondly remember. God graced us with these times so that we may grow closer together as a class, enabling us to overcome the troubled times. Through sports teams, clubs, and classes, we have found our place in the Bishop Eustace community. Unending bonds of friendship are the foundations that have allowed our class to move forward even after difficult events. We did not crumble. Our class drove on to sit here together today. It is this unity that makes us unique. We have driven through the past 4 years and learned the lessons that they have had to offer. The question is, how will we apply these lessons to our lives? We have already begun to do so. Through our service projects, we have delayed our own journey to pull over and help others. We have each contributed our individual God-given talents and strengths to innumerable volunteer and outreach programs to aid those in need. These are the signs of God working through us to provide others with the same resolve and hope that we had needed during troubled times. And as a result of these experiences, we will continue this tradition long after our time at Bishop Eustace expires. But all of this is in the past. What matters now is that we are sitting here today, anxious and scared about the future. Moving from Eustace students to Eustace alumni, we will no longer feel the security of coming back to school after the summer and seeing hallways filled with familiar faces. We will not have the comfort of close relationships surrounding us. No, from this point forward, we can only take the memories with us as we venture into the unknown alone. But we are not alone. Our tenure at Eustace has equipped us with the experience, talents, and God at our side. Robert Frost wrote that before him, two roads diverged in a woods. Before you lie not just two, but an infinite number of roadways. This is the next stretch of road in your journey. It is your choice which path to follow. A wise man travels light on the road trip of life. Wisdom is his map, wonder his fuel, and a good story his favorite souvenir. On this, your graduation day, take time to look forward to all of life's possibilities and all you have yet to see, to do, to be, and wonder, where will your journey take you? Congratulations to the class of 2003, and may all of you have a prosperous journey.
Thank you, Michael. At this time, I would like to welcome our principal, Mr. Cyril J. Bleistein, for a few remarks.
Thank you very much, brother. Hello, everyone. really sunny in here, isn't it? About the only thing yellow around is this folder that I brought over. We worked very hard to get the weather to cooperate. It didn't. We got our answer. We need more rain. Right? It's always exciting for me to have the privilege of celebrating a graduation with the students of our school, soon to be graduates, and their parents and their relatives and friends. I'm going to have a difficult time with this one, though, because as I think a number of you know, I also have a child in this class who is graduating. You may not also know, but she's our youngest child, by a long shot, if you understand what I mean. But I thought I was in a unique position until I started checking the class list, going through it, and I discovered that there are at least 35 other families in this particular class in the same situation that I am in that they have their youngest child graduating from Bishop Eustace today. I was amazed by that, and so I hope you, 35 anyway, understand how I am feeling with my youngest child graduating today. And I thought I would take a little liberty, not only on behalf of those 35 families, but all of the families in this present class, to say some special thank yous to some people who have made the past 4 years at Bishop Eustace, I think, a challenging, enjoyable, and compassionate experience for these 201 lovely young people. And of course, I want to start right away by thanking the Palatine fathers and brothers who own and operate Bishop Eustace Preparatory School. I thank them, for without them, I don't know whether my children would have been able to come to Bishop Eustace. I thank them because they give us, in Father Joe Capella, our rector, and Brother Jim Beamsdurfer, our Dean of Men, two outstanding people who provide profound spiritual example and guidance to these young people. And we are very happy about that. We have, at Bishop Eustace, an extremely talented group of people who we call the faculty. And that's an academic term, meaning those people who teach your sons and daughters. But I have to tell you that these people are far more than faculty. Because they give so much of themselves to help your children grow, not only academically, but as persons. They commit day in and day out, during the school day, after the school day, in the evenings, and on Saturdays and Sundays, to ensure that the young folks that we have before us today are fully formed and headed in the right direction. And I would like you to thank them today. Finally, or not finally, there are two other groups of people that we sometimes overlook, and that's the secretarial staff and the maintenance staff at Bishop Eustace. You would be surprised at the amount of counseling that goes on in some of the secretarial offices at Bishop Eustace. we would not be in this building celebrating this graduation today were it not for the men who came here a little before 8 o'clock this morning to help move everything from outside where it was and bring it in here so that we could celebrate this wonderful event today. And that's our maintenance staff. And finally, helping the maintenance staff today were parents who came this morning at 8 o'clock on the promise of donuts and coffee to help our maintenance staff have everything ready. I will embarrass him, but I'm going to say it anyway because I turned around and there was a senior parent here. I said, "You're not supposed to be here today." He says, "I got to help out. I got the call." That's Mr. Flager. Thank you, Mr. Flager, very, very much. And the person who organized the parents to be here and some of our students to be here was Mrs. Sharon Larkin. And Sharon, you did a great job. To all of the parents here today, thank you for 4 or more years of assistance and support in helping us and allowing us to educate your children. Graduates, please, if you would, give your parents a large round of applause because they deserve it. We talk at Bishop Eustace about family. It's more than talk. It's ingrained in our existence. I think my comments to you this afternoon reflect the family atmosphere that is Bishop Eustace. It's not something that trips from our tongue. It's meant deeply and from our heart. And parents, we hope that your children will continue the fine tradition that you have established to continue to help our school be the school that it is. In my mind, the finest in the area. And finally, to the graduates, you have done an outstanding job. You truly have. You have done an outstanding job athletically. I'm sorry, I wanted to say academically, and athletically came out. Academically, in dramatics, in music, and in athletics, and spiritually. Those of you who have participated in the renewals, and particularly those of you who have participated in the Kairos retreats, have brought a new meaning to what it means to be a graduate of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School. I have to put in a plug, because if you read the paper this morning, you know that our girls track team won the parochial A track championship for the state of New Jersey yesterday. I put that plug in because Ms. Hughes threatened to say some nasty things to me if I didn't mention that. That's not true. But I mention it because I think it highlights what this class has done and in what they have accomplished. I bring a message to the class, and the message is from our rector, Father Joe. Yes, I had an opportunity to speak with Father Joe on Friday. For all of you, he's making wonderful progress. But the person I spoke with on the telephone, because of his difficulties, you would not recognize. He's very weak at this time, and he's on a lot of medication. But he wanted all of you to know how proud he was of you, how much he wanted to be here today to celebrate with you, and how much he wishes you every success and God's grace as you leave Bishop Eustace Preparatory School. Graduates, in a moment, we will award you your diplomas. You've earned them. Great job. Remember one thing. You always have a home at Bishop Eustace Preparatory School. Thank you. At this time, I would ask Brother Jim and Dr. Diamore to join me for the awarding of the diplomas.
Mr. Bleistein, it is my honor and pleasure to present to you the members of the class of 2003 who have successfully completed the requirements of our Board of Trustees and are awarded diplomas. Those students wearing the gold stoles are members of the National Honor Society. Jill Ashley Attica. Alexis Michelle Aloy. Joseph Christopher Ambrosi. Nicole Elise Amade. Catherine Elizabeth Anderson. Janine Tess Andreo. Barbara Catherine Angelino. Jenna Lee Angerstein. Spirangelis Antipas. Michael Lawrence Antonelli. Rita Marie Appalucci. Ryan William Arndt. Della J. Atu Swanzi. Jessica Ann Bailey. Megan Lee Baker. William Joseph Barnes. Gianna Benedetto. Stephen P. Bernardi. Vanessa Catherine Bernardin. Courtney A. Blake. Megan Eileen Bleistein. Christine Bridget Bloom. Michael Bornman. Bridget Rachel Basson. Angela Marie Boyer. Amanda Gabrielle Green. David Paul Biro. Danielle Marie Cachese. Jessica Catherine Campbell. Jacqueline Ann Cancellari. Jeffrey Michael Capelli. Christopher Brian Cardillo. Caitlin Elizabeth Carrigan. Ryan Anthony Carosa. Melissa Rose Caton. Melanie Ann Chapman. Mark James Christopher Jr. Erica Beth Ciccatelli. Sarita Marie Sini. Brendan David Connor. Jacqueline Lorraine Connolly. Robert Salvatore Consalvo Jr. Michael J. Corcoran. Laura Elizabeth Cordero. Melissa Coyle. Charles David Kramer. Kelly Ann Prellman. Rosemary Culbertson. Jessica Cedrone D'Amato. Laura Rose Davis. Louis DeGeorge III. Danielle Regina DeRosa. Jason Stephen Devlin. James Salvatore DiBella. Daniel Patrick Dillon. Jacqueline DeRubo. Christopher Thomas DeVitro. Daniel Timothy Dombrowski. Timothy James Dudek. Erica Lee Dunauer. Catherine Marie Egger. Daniel Christopher Fowler. Andrew Thomas Fallon. Megan Farrell. Ryan Charles Fitzpatrick. Stephanie Flaherty. Christopher Scott Fossarelli. Megan Kathleen Foster. John David Frangipani. Mark Allen Garlett. Erin Elizabeth Giroux. Patricia Emily Giroux. Justin Lewis Giandrea. Maria Anna Giannopoulos. Derek L. Gogol. Nicholas M. Graysberry. Laura Marie Greenwood. Allison Marie Groey. Denise Colleen Grubert. Courtney Elizabeth Heron. Colin Michael Harrington. Alicia Patrice Arita Hayes. Jason E. Healy. Michael Ashley Hicks. Lauren Morgan Hill. Adam Holman. Michael Allen Hoyt. Allison Amanda Humphreys. Nicholas E. Iannucci. Vincent Patrick Jackson. Stephen Jacobs. Jennifer Johnston. Ryan C. Johnstone. Chad Michael Kendra. William John Kennedy. Nicole Keys. Abigail Karen Kinn. Matthew Kevin Kinbeck. Ashley Suzanne Klein. Agatha Elizabeth Klug. Catherine Marie Kochansky. Mark Christopher Kohler. Evan Doyle Kostka. Lauren Michelle Kramer. Robert Joseph Krowicki, Jr. Adrian Denise Kukma. Thomas A. Langerman. Caitlin Lavoie. Donna Marie Leeson. Jonathan Francis Lind. Jeffrey J. Long. Jomil Luna. Kelly A. Lyons. Patrick Scott McAdams. Ashley Elizabeth Melandry. Kara Regina Manning. Robert A. Marmion, Jr. Lauren Alicia Elizabeth Matisse. Kyle Joseph Matula. Dana L. Malgieri. Jessica Victoria May. Erin Elizabeth McCarthy. Brendan James McCord. Daniel McCormick. Marie Christine McDermott. Catherine Ann McGovern. Christopher Anthony Meckley. Rachel Michelle Messina. Stephanie Jean Mischick. Dominique Mitchell. Susan Rebecca Maraca. Marissa Rowan Moser. Billy Motto. Paul Stephen Mullen. Michael R. Muller. John Thomas Murphy. Patrick Brian Murray. John O. Noss III. Victoria M. Nicodemo. Gregory Joseph Neat. Ashley Nowakowski. Katie Colleen O'Brien. Corinne Marie Polanti. Megan Victoria Pancella. Jonathan F. Paolini. George Papanier. Daniel Adam Pascal. Janet May Passananti. Jason R. Perocho. Justin Michael Persichetti. Doran Lane Peterson. Joseph M. Petrangelo, Jr. Matthew Richard Petruzzi. Andrew G. Flager. Lon Pham. Michael Pignataro. Jacqueline F. Holland. Danielle Yvonne Ponzio. AJ Pothan. Derek James Potter. Joel Julian Pratt. Laura Ashley Krell. Jacqueline Ann Presbukowski. Kathleen B. Raditich. Michael James Regina. Stephanie Rebecca Reichert. Leanne Riley. Fernando J. Ricard. Erin N. Sabina. Jamie Lynn Sawyer. Thomas Michael Shantz. Lauren Elizabeth Shivo. Christine Ruth Schneider. Caitlin Meredith Scott. Joseph Lewis Seiler. Sarah Ray Sensendiver. Jennifer Marie Serrano. Jenna Ann Schenk. Lauren Abigail Silver. Lauren Elizabeth Scaff. Nicholas Michael Smiraski. Thomas Jonathan Smith. Francesca M. Spadafora. Danielle Ann Still. Jonathan Mark Suarez. Anthony Joseph Tallarico. Erin Lee Tebow. Domenica Lauren Toscani. Cheryl Tumalo. Sean Colin Terzansky. Jennifer Ann Ursa Marso. Kyle Edward Velitato. Daniel John Vitale. Jeffrey Jacob Wade. Michael Victor Wagner. Tony Marie Walton. Kevin Thomas Whalen. Kelly Costino Wishnick. Eileen Marguerite Wickstead. Troy George William Yohas. Sean Patrick Zale. On Wednesday evening, May 28, 2003, our annual senior awards ceremony was held. The following students of the class of 2003 distinguished themselves in the particularly following areas. I would ask that each senior please stand at your place in order to be recognized when your name is announced. The General Excellence Awards were presented to Allison Amanda Humphreys and Lauren Alicia Elizabeth Matisse. The Award for Excellence in the Study of English was presented to Melanie Ann Chapman. The Award for Excellence in the Study of Theology and Latin were presented to Alexis Michelle Aloy. The Award for Excellence in the Study of Science was presented to Michael Lawrence Antonelli. The Award for Excellence in the Study of Mathematics was presented to Charles David Kramer. The Award for Excellence in the Study of German was presented to Jeffrey Jacob Wade. The Award for Excellence in the Study of French was presented to Bridget Rachel Besson. The award for excellence in the study of Spanish was presented to Lauren Alicia Elizabeth Matisse. The award for excellence in the study of health and physical education was presented to Laura Rose Davis. The award for excellence in interdisciplinary studies was presented to Laura Ashley Prell. The award for excellence in the study of history was presented to Katie Colleen O'Brien. The awards for excellence in the study of art history was presented to Christopher Thomas DeVitro. The award for excellence in the study of music was presented to Nicholas Michael Smiraski. The Scholar Athlete Award was presented to Megan Eileen Bleistein. The Leadership Award was presented to Justin Lewis Giandrea. In 1985, the Board of Trustees of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School directed that a program be designed that would challenge and enrich the most talented and gifted students attending our school. The program is called the Cum Laude Program. 10 members of the class of 2003 have qualified for the various awards in this very demanding and rigorous program. They were very diligent in their efforts and have produced quality papers and projects. The best of these will be placed in our library for use by all students at the prep. There are three categories of the Cum Laude Award: the Summa Cum Laude Award, the Magna Cum Laude Award, and the Cum Laude Award. This year, all 10 students received the Summa Cum Laude Award, which is the award recognizing students who satisfy the basic requirements and maintain a 3.85 weighted cumulative grade point average. This award was presented to the following students: Alexis Michelle Aloy, Laura Rose Davis, Allison Amanda Humphreys, Agatha Elizabeth Klug, Lauren Alicia Elizabeth Matisse, Kyle Joseph Matula, Erin Elizabeth McCarthy, Danielle Yvonne Ponzio, Lauren Elizabeth Shivo, and Danielle Ann Still. At this time, I would like to introduce Mr. Frank Masso, a graduate of the class of 1962 and president of the Bishop Eustace Alumni Association. Mr. Masso.
Thank you. And greetings from the Bishop Eustace Alumni Association. In keeping with the tradition of family that we have here at Eustace, 5 years ago we started a tradition where the class 40 years previous to the one graduating would lead the graduates into the ceremony. And unfortunately, because of the weather, they weren't able to do that. But I'd like to introduce you to the members that represent the class of 1963. And they are Mr. Pete Johnson, if you would please stand. Dominic Favieri. And Mr. Jim Whitaker. It's a great tradition. And next year it'll be the class of 64. I'm reminded of our family traditions here, especially this morning at about 2:30 a.m. I was feeding my granddaughter, Isabella. And she is the daughter of Christopher and Amy, who are both graduates of Bishop Eustace. Amy's dad is also a graduate of Bishop Eustace, the first class, 1958. And of course, I am too. And I was trying to wake up while I was trying to find her mouth to feed her. And she had a bib on that said, B.E. Future Crusader. And of course, the development office takes care of that. They send out these bibs to all the new babies that are born to graduates. That's really terrific. But today I'm here to present an award to one of the graduates for that'll be a $1,000 scholarship that'll be given to the college or university of the student who exemplifies the principles and the traditions of the Bishop Eustace Alumni Association. And I'm proud to present this award to Mark Kohler. Thank you once again, Mr. Masso. On behalf of the alumni members of the Bishop Eustace faculty, I would like to present Mr. Edward Wozniak, class of 1995.
Thank you, Dr. Diemwer. In 1984, the alumni faculty of Bishop Eustace Prep, with the cooperation and blessing of the Palatines, established a $1,200 scholarship award to be given each year to a member of the senior class. The alumni faculty will directly contribute to this scholarship to the college or university of the selected senior to help defray the cost of the student's first year. I would ask that the alumni faculty please stand at this time for the presentation of the scholarship. By this award, the alumni faculty wishes to honor the senior who has displayed what we believe to be the cornerstones of a Bishop Eustace education: consistent academic achievement commensurate with the student's skills and talents, a dedication to service and self-improvement through participation in extracurricular activities and community activities, an honest and personal integrity that reflects an excellence of character, and most importantly, a spiritual awareness and concern for humankind that echoes the values of St. Vincent Pallotti and his community of priests and brothers. It is my great honor, on behalf of the alumni faculty, to present this alumni faculty scholarship to Laura Ashley Prell.
Parents Association has established the Reverend Ralph F. Fernino Memorial Scholarship to be awarded to a male and female graduate who, during their time at Bishop Eustace, has embodied the characteristics that best exemplify the joyous spirit of Father Ralph. These graduates demonstrate exceptional dedication to and love for Bishop Eustace and a faith in God that is manifested within the day-to-day context of their vocation as a member of our school community. The scholarship is in the amount of $2,500 for each student. At this time, I am very pleased to present the Father Ralph F. Fernino Memorial Scholarship Awards to Justin Lewis Giandrea, and Laura Elizabeth Shiva. In 1981, the Board of Trustees established the St. Vincent Pallotti Award to be presented to a male and a female student who distinguish themselves and best exemplify the Palatine ideals of a Christian viewpoint of life, scholastic achievement, responsible citizenship, and a deepening and searching faith, a genuine concern for the poor, and a growing commitment to ministry in the church. Like St. Vincent Pallotti, these individuals are a reflection of the self-giving love of Jesus. This year, the students receiving the St. Vincent Pallotti Awards are Megan Eileen Bleistein, and Andrew Thomas Fallon.
I would like to call your attention to the many scholarships and grants won by the class of 2003, which are printed in the graduation program. Please join me in recognizing their fine achievement with a well-deserved round of applause. I would now ask Mr. Bleistein to come forward to introduce Dr. Coughlin.
Thank you very much, Brother Jim. For the past 12 years, Dr. David Coughlin has served as superintendent of schools for the Diocese of Camden. During that time, he has worked tirelessly for all the students of all Catholic schools of the diocese to ensure that each received a high-quality Catholic education. Dr. Coughlin has decided to lead the superintendency and on July the 1st will become the new president of Paul VI High School while still serving as superintendent until a successor is found. During his tenure as superintendent, we at Bishop Eustace have benefited greatly from his sound advice, unqualified support, and visionary efforts for the advancement of Catholic education. We have always looked on him as a very special friend of our community. Because of this, it is my honor, on behalf of the entire Bishop Eustace community, to present a plaque and gift to him. The plaque reads, Dr. David T. Coughlin, Superintendent of Schools, Diocese of Camden. In recognition of your years of service to all the students of the Diocese of Camden, and with grateful appreciation from the Bishop Eustace Preparatory School community. Thank you, Dr. Coughlin, for your many years of wise and compassionate service as our Superintendent of Schools. May God continue to be with you as you assume your new responsibilities as president of Paul VI High School. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I would like to introduce Dr. David Coughlin.
Thank you, Mr. Bleistein, and thank all of you in the Bishop Eustace community. Reality is a hot term these days. Reality television programs have become so popular that reportedly a new cable TV station will be devoted exclusively to those shows. Survivor, The Amazing Race, The Bachelor and Bachelorette, these programs entertain by showing us a group of dedicated people who are ruthlessly and deceitfully often pursuing some monetary or relational goal. This summer's most popular movie sequel is a story of a computer-generated illusion whereby computers and technology take over the world. Replete with pseudo-religious and psychological names such as Trinity, the One, the Oracle, this is a tale of those who are desperately trying to escape a virtual reality that dictates and controls their lives. These questions, what is real? What is true? What is the good life and how do I go about living it, are some of the oldest ones in human experience. You, the 2003 graduates of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School, will be faced with answering those questions in your own lives. Is life no more than a mad rush to accumulate material goods and wealth and status? Will our lives be controlled by the seductive allure of television programs, movies, computer games, compact discs, or is there a more rewarding approach to life? For the past 4 years, you've had the inestimable privilege of being exposed to the most important and satisfying answer to life's big questions. Jesus Christ told his first followers, "I am the truth and the way and the life." He taught them by word and example that he came not to be served by others, but to serve them, and that the most satisfying life was to be found not by accumulating more status or material goods than others, but by sacrificing oneself for the good of others. For the past 4 years, you, the graduates, have had wonderful role models, as Mr. Bleistein reminded us earlier, and seeing how that message is lived. You've had parents who cared so much for you that they were willing to make the sacrifices needed to give you the very best, a Catholic high school education at Bishop Eustace Preparatory School. You've had teachers who were willing to make the personal sacrifices to show you day in and day out how the Christian life is lived. And you've had the Palatine religious community to show you the special power of a life consecrated wholly to Christ and his church. Now it is time for you to go out into the world, to your dormitories and college classrooms, to your families and neighborhoods, to your workplaces and professions, and to show others the power and the rewards of a life lived in conformity with the ultimate reality, the gospel. On behalf of Bishop DiMarzio and the Diocese of Camden, I congratulate you and your families upon this important accomplishment and wish you God's presence in everything that you do. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Coughlin. To render the farewell address on behalf of the class of 2003, please welcome Caitlin Elizabeth Carrigan.
Good afternoon, Dr. Coughlin, Mr. Bleistein, Palatines, honored guests, administration, faculty, parents, family, friends, and fellow graduates. These past 4 years have been simply a journey marred by potholes and hurdles, by triumphs that have shaped the minds and the souls of the graduates you see here before you. As I reflect, I find myself amazed at the people we have become. Not only good individuals, but an amazing family. The pathways of reflection are surprising, and many memories come to my mind. This class has lost and gained teachers, surrendered classmates and friends, yet only to make new ones in their stead. We have had triumphs and failures in the name of learning, and seen events that will forever change how our generation views the world. Yet, through all these things, our class has remained a family. Deterred by the little things, but united in friendship and community. Dr. D'Amore, our esteemed vice principal, said to me once, "Mr. Bleistein and Father Joe think of you kids as children, their children." Though to some this comment seemed unimportant, it stuck with me for a long time. I came to realize that this class was not only one of family in the sense of sibling community. We were something more. We were children. You see, we are all children of some kind. We are children of God, children of our parents, children of our generation, and yes, even children of this school, of this community, and this family. For 4 years, 5 days a week, and 6 hours a day, this class has traveled from one home to another. Here we have found parents, those teachers who taught us the hard lessons and guided us with caring. We have found brothers and sisters in our fellow classmates who taught us about life and equally about ourselves. Most of all, this community has become our home. As these thoughts of family began to take shape in my mind, I recalled something from my own childhood. For as long as I can remember, a plaque has hung in my room. As a child, I could not understand the language nor the message. As I grew, though I deciphered the message, its true meaning has escaped me until now. You see, the plaque reads, "There are only two lasting bequests we can give our children. One is roots, the other wings." Though many of us are desperate and eager to assert our newly granted adultness, I say that we are also still and forever will be children. As Dr. D'Amore told me, we are children of our administration, of this community, of this four-year home. We have made our roots. In this home, the men and women of tomorrow have been shaped, and the first step begins today. The family that we have formed here will last forever, as too will many friendships. Most importantly, we have had spent some of the most important years of our life here, building the people that we have become. The cement has been poured, the foundation laid, and our roots have taken hold. Now, the challenge is to spread those newfound wings, instilled in us by this family, and fly into the world that awaits. We have other wings, those crafted by our parents, those by our faith, and even those by our own experience. Yet these wings are different and special. In this home, we have been given every tool to excel. In our 4 years, we have met and conquered innumerable challenges. Others, we have not overcome, but learned from just the same. We have learned catechism, and with that, faith and trust in God. We have learned how to be friends and how to be teachers, how to learn and to grow. We have learned agony and defeat and triumph and success. Most of all, we have learned of ourselves. Each one of us has crafted unique wings, designed with our own future in mind, able to take us wherever we need to go in life. So, I leave you with this. Spread your newfound wings and fly into the real world. Seize your dreams and become the individual that you have molded here. Dare to disturb the universe, as the saying goes. But I offer you this challenge. Never forget your roots. Live your life according to the person that you have become in your time here. Try as you might to forget, this place will never forget you. You are an extension of this community, of this family, a representation of its best. So, to the men and to the women of the class of 2003, I ask you to go into the world and be successful. But always remember, as far as those wings take you, you are never too far to find your way home again.
Thank you, Caitlin. The class dedication to St. Vincent Pallotti will now be given by the president of the class of 2003, Justin Lewis Giandria. Will the members of the class of 2003 please stand and remain standing during the dedication? And please remain standing following the dedication.
We, the graduating class of 2003, ask you, St. Vincent Pallotti, patron of our school, to intercede for us to be forever attached to our alma mater, inspired by the Catholic faith and devoted to American democracy. We dedicate ourselves to live your ideals of reviving faith, fostering charity, and promoting unity among all peoples. Amen.
Thank you, Justin. I would now ask Lauren Shivo to come forward to lead us in the singing of the Alma Mater. The Alma Mater is printed on the inside back cover of the graduation program. Please rise.
With pride and spirit we hold high our banner black and white, united by the thanks and loyalty for values formed and honors earned through our community. With loving arms and honest hearts, we built our friendship strong. Bishop Eustace, forever will
Please be seated. If you follow in the program, it says the benediction will be given, which is a blessing. There's a slight change. Before the closing prayer of the graduation today, I'm deviating from the script. Bishop Eustace is a lot more than buildings, the quad, so it rained. We still had a great time. Bishop Eustace is built on faith. And last night at the Baccalaureate Mass, Mr. Bleistein made a very nice and quite humbling comment about Father Joe and myself, that we have dedicated our lives to educating children. I would ask the faculty to please stand, and the staff. These are the people who dedicated their lives to the children. The staff, the administration, and the faculty, we do this for one reason. It's not the paycheck. We do this because of love. This is the result of our work. What better reward? On behalf of Father Amato, the president of the Board of Trustees, and of Father Joe, I want to congratulate all the parents, but most of all, I want to congratulate my children. For the closing prayer, I'd ask you to remain seated because I came up with it's a storyline, but it's a prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Blessed are you, Lord our God, for you have created a wide and wonderful world in which we travel. We ask your blessing upon us as we are about to leave Eustace. Be our ever near companion, O holy guide, and spread the road before us with beauty and adventure. May all the highways ahead of us be free of harm and evil. May we be accompanied by your holy spirits, your angelic messengers, as were the holy ones in the days past. As we take leave of Bishop Eustace, may we take with us, as part of our traveling equipment, a heart wrapped in wonder with which to rejoice in all that we shall meet. Along with wonder, may we have room in our luggage for a mystical map by which we can find the invisible meaning of life. Always alert to your sacred presence and to your divine compassionate love, may we see in all that happens to us, the beautiful and the bad, the mystery of your holy plan. May the blessing of your name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be upon us as we leave Eustace. Amen. We, the administration, the faculty, the staff, and the Palatines, take this opportunity to thank you for your attendance at this 46th commencement. And we ask that the parents and relatives and friends remain in their places until the dignitaries and the graduates exit. Thank you and good afternoon.